Hello and welcome to Advanced Markets Workshop on Automated Trading. This workshop is presented by myself, Natalia Hunik, Chief Revenue Officer, and Rafael Ribacourt, VP of Institutional Sales at Advanced Markets Group. Today we will talk about all the good, bad, and ugly on FX automated trading. And I will pass it on to Rafael to cover our agenda and several types of automated trading.
Thank you, Natalia, and welcome everyone to our virtual workshop. So according to Deutsche Bank, 90% of equity futures trades are executed without any human input. Since the 1970s, when the era of floating exchange rates began, technical trading has become widespread in the foreign exchange markets. A study in 2016 showed that over 80% of trading in the forex market was performed by trading algorithms rather than humans. But there is a world of difference between the equity markets and the foreign exchange markets. In stocks, there are myriad public and private trading venues from which to use algorithms, upwards of 40, while the forex market is traded by or on a handful of bank trading desks, also known as a pre-simple bank trading market or spot forward market. Banks use algorithms to trade among themselves, and they sell them to clients for fees. As a result, computer-driven trading has been far slower to catch on than in stocks. Today, we will review characteristics of the common automated strategies in the FX market and talk about implementation challenges for each strategy, as well as the prospects of implementing these strategies as the matching FX brokers. Specifically, we will dive into the following specialized strategies: high-frequency trading, HFT, arbitrage, scalping, quantitative or quant trading. Making use of arbitrage in algorithmic trading means that the system hunts for price imbalances across different markets and makes profits of those. Arbitrage opportunities are usually short-lived, so you need to act fast. However, since the forex price differences are usually only micropips, you will need to trade relatively large positions to make considerable profits. There are a few traditional arbitrage strategies in FX. Triangular arbitrage, which involves two currency pairs and a currency cross between the two. It's also a popular strategy under this classification. Triangular arbitrage is based on geometric relationship between three currency pairs. Covered interest arbitrage. It uses a strategy of arbitraging the interest rate differentials between spot and forward contract markets in order to hedge interest rate risk in currency markets. These traditional arbitrage strategies have been known since the 80s, and the consensus is that they rarely work in today's market, as over time, markets move towards a greater efficiency. Some of the more margin FX-specific arbitrage strategies are latency arbitrage. It's a high-frequency trading strategy used to front-run trading orders in equities trading. In equities markets, these strategies are often labeled as predatory due to the front-running orders and rebate arbitrage strategies. In FX, latency arbitrage typically is price latency arbitrage, where the trader finds delayed prices on the broker's platforms and exploits that deficiency. Cross-broker arbitrage. To use this technique, you need at least two separate broker accounts, and ideally some software to monitor the quotes and alert you when there is a discrepancy between your price feeds. You can also use software to backtest your feeds for arbitrageable opportunities. Variances can come about for a few reasons: timing differences, software, positioning, as well as different quotes between price makers. Technology arbitrage. When a broker's quote momentarily diverges from the broader market, a trader can arbitrage these events. This will allow a risk-free profit. In truth, there are challenges. Some institutional traders may exploit deficiencies in retail FX platforms while having access to primary FX markets on EBS or Reuters. Event arbitrage. It refers to the group of trading strategies that place trades on the basis of the market's reaction to event. The events may be economic or industry-specific occurrences that consistently affect the securities of interest time and time again. For example, many FX strategies are centered around arbitraging on major news announcements before the market reacts to it. All of these price discrepancies might not last very long because there are other traders out there watching prices and hoping to take advantage of the spread too. So speed is of the essence. Arbitrage strategies implementation challenges. Collocation and speed and technology. Arbitrage strategies are also known as grabbing pennies on the railroad track. So speed is of the essence. This requires investment in infrastructure and technology, collocation with trading venues, transaction costs. Since profits are very small, depending on the brokerage, one needs to fully estimate transaction costs. Some strategies are also not sustainable. You need to manage many accounts, and as many brokers do not allow any form of arbitrage, you run the risk of having your account suspended at any time. HFT, or High Frequency Trading. As the name suggests, this kind of trading system operates at lightning-fast speeds, executing buy or sell signals and closing trades in a matter of milliseconds. These typically use arbitrage or scalping strategies based on quick price fluctuations and involves high trading volumes. High-frequency traders rely on extremely low latencies and use high-speed connections in conjunction with trading algorithms to exploit inefficiencies created by these exchanges. High-frequency traders can conduct trades in approximately 164 millionths of a second. This is roughly the time it takes for a computer to process an order and send it out to another machine. High-frequency traders in Forex generate revenue from attempting to capture small changes or the difference between the bid-offer spreads in other locations. As you can see from the graphs provided by the Bank of International Settlement, share of HFT trading in FX has been steadily growing. HFT strategies implementation challenges, speed. At the time of writing, market contacts suggest that some HFT participants in FX can operate with latency of less than 1 millisecond, compared with 10-30 milliseconds for most upper-tier non-HFT participants. In equities, this internal processing time is 164 millionths of a second. However, execution speed in FX is far behind equities trading. As you can see, Nasdaq can execute orders in less than 1 millisecond, while the fastest margin FX brokers out there will be around 85 milliseconds. Advanced Markets, for example, is an institutional broker and offers higher execution speed, averaging, depending on your location, at around 50 milliseconds, with internal processing time of less than 1 millisecond. Market data delivered in 500 millisecond packets will likely be unsuited for HFT strategy. So you need to find venues that can price faster. For some, it's technical limitation. For example, Advanced Markets is extending platform limitation and can push up to 100 updates into MT4 in a second. There are other limiting factors to HFT strategy, like fill ratio, as the consequences of missing a large number of trades due to unfilled orders are likely to be catastrophic for any HFT strategy.
Scalping is another subtype of high-frequency trading. It involves entering trades and closing them after a short time in order to make profits from small price changes. If you watch a chart for any liquid asset, you will see that the price is constantly changing. Scalpers profit from these movements. Some of the challenges for implementing scalping strategies in FX include that it's risky in volatile markets. It tends to work best in range-bound markets. Some brokers don't allow scalping as it is not suitable for their risk management strategy. Diligent cost controls need to be applied. Spreads and other cost factors need to be carefully examined. Fill rates can destroy strategy profits if trades are rejected or slipped. Quantitative trading is a type of automated market strategy that relies on mathematical and statistical models to identify and often execute opportunities. The models are driven by quantitative analysis, which is where the strategy gets its name from. It's frequently referred to as quant trading, or sometimes just quant. Quantitative trading works by using data-driven models to determine the probability of a certain outcome happening. Unlike other forms of trading, it relies solely on statistical methods and programming to do this. Challenges for implementing quant strategies. Lack of data availability in foreign exchange market as compared to equities is one of the major obstacles in implementing quant strategies in FX. Since the Forex market regarded as an over-the-counter or OTC market and does not transact on a centralized exchange, there is little uniform data available. The FX ECNs only published approximately 15% of their data while the rest of the market trades in the dark. Only estimated 6% of the market is covered by good quality data. Algos need data, such as volume traded per unit of time, in order to properly slice a large order into smaller pieces. Also, many traders underestimate the cost for quality data. You can get some of the historical tick-by-tick data dating back to 1992, but it will cost you tens of thousands of dollars. So, is it possible to implement alpha-generating strategies on margin retail FX platforms? The answer is yes, but your algorithm needs to have an adaptive reinforcement learning layer that will optimize trailing stop levels, trading thresholds, trading costs, learning rate, and audit shutdown critical loss parameter. As you can see on the screen, this is a schematic of a typical algorithmic FX strategy that has three layers. Machine learning layer that mines the data, layer number two is the risk management, and layer number three is dynamic optimization level I just talked about. Risk management. One of the major upsides of automated trading is also its Achilles heel. If computers can make winning trades very quickly, they can make losing trades just as quickly. If the system starts to enter into losing positions, it will do so very fast, and you might stack up on substantial losses before you know what happened. Algorithmic trading is largely blamed for creating market anomalies known as flash crashes. When a trade goes bad, a psychological tendency exists to keep the position open in the hope that the market will reverse its course and the trade will be profitable again. This implies a risk-seeking attitude towards losses as opposed to risk aversion with regards to profits. However, the market could very well not reverse itself and eventually force the closeout of the position at a huge loss. This characteristic of human psychology needs to be avoided by a successful automated trading system. Risk management avoids this pitfall by building a trailing stop loss for every trade. A stop loss is set and adjusted so that it's always X basis points under or above the best price ever reached during the life of the position. So what are the typical mistakes made by the traders when designing an automated trading system in FX? Number one is that they presume ideal conditions, like no hidden costs, quality data, brokers' honesty and integrity, no catastrophic black swan events. These conditions simply do not exist in fragmented OTC FX market that lacks a great deal of transparency. Number two is all-in trading costs are not factored in. Apart from commissions, there are spreads, slippage, rejects, requotes, missed quotes, system downtimes that all need to be considered in and built into your models. Number three is execution speed and liquidity largely differ from broker to broker. And number four is slippage being underestimated by many models back-tested in ideal conditions or tested on demo. Slippage, market impact, and other factors play a huge role in success of your automated trading strategy. So how can advanced markets help you today to get started with implementing your algorithmic trading strategy into your currency markets portfolio? Advanced markets is an institutional brokerage with first-tier access to bank and hedge fund liquidity. We're primed by UBS and Standard Chartered and offer access to over 14 venues that include banks and quantitative hedge funds. We are licensed by the UK FCA and ASIC in Australia. We offer fixed API trading with co-location available. We also have depth of market available on our fixed API and on all our platforms. Our high tick frequency update rate will help your high frequency trading algorithmic strategies to run faster. We offer FX, metals, CFDs on indices, crypto, and single stocks on all our platforms. And finally, our pricing engines are located in Equinix data centers in New York and London. Please contact us today to learn about how to get started. Thank you for listening and tuning in into our Advanced Markets channel at Finance Magnets Virtual Expo. Thank you and have a great day.